Hi friends, if you like my videos, if you like my explanation, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.
Hi friends, my name is Farindra. So in this video, let us discuss about the introduction of parasites, type of parasites and the disease which they cause. Okay, so normally the discovery of the parasite. So Charles Louis Alphonse Levrin is a scientist who discovered the theory of the parasite and what is meant by parasite. He given the definition of the parasite and he also given the structure of the parasites, type of parasites, each and everything he had discovered about the parasite. And he won Nobel Prize in 1907 for his work based on his medicine. Okay, so coming to the second one, what is the definition which was given by the scientist of parasite? A parasite is an organism that lives in another organism which is known as host and often harms it. That's nothing but normally what is the main function of the parasite? The parasite nothing but normally parasite will kill an organism. So here organism is nothing but host, is nothing but humans or as animals. So normally parasite grows, the life cycle of the parasite begins from the fecus matter which we release. So normally fecus matter consists of eggs, right? And the hatching of the eggs takes place at the stage of fecus matter itself. So after, when we consume the contaminated food and water which consists of that eggs, you know, the with the help of mosquitoes like flies, okay, with the help of that flies, what happens, that eggs or as the larva which has been released out will be carried out by the flies and will be into water and as well as the food. So the water and food will get contaminated. So that contaminated food and water will be intake by us human beings. So often what happens, even the human beings will also get damaged. I mean, even they will also get attacked. So that's what given here. A parasite is an organism. A parasite is a living organism that lives in another organism. That's nothing but in human beings. And that human beings are called as host. Not only human beings, but also in animals also. So in most of the cases, you can see this type of parasites in animals only. Because we will take proper food and water which has been washed properly, even vegetables like if you see. But if you see in the case of animals, what happens? It will eat whatever it want. Like example, if you see in pig, right? It will eat fecus matter which we release, like that. So in most of the cases, you can see this type of infections which are caused by the parasites only in the animals, but rarely you can see in cases of human beings also, if we take improper food and water. Okay, next, normally here host plays a major role. Host is nothing but, which I have said you now itself, human beings as well as the animals. Human beings and animals play a major role for the living of these parasites. So if there is no host, then there will be no parasite. Then there will be no parasite. Living of the parasite doesn't take place. So why? Because the life cycle of the parasite begins from the fecus matter. But the life cycle, reproduction takes place in the intestine of our body. Not in our body, but also in the animals also, right? So here, host plays a major role. So normally, we know that there are many digestion enzymes which will be produced in our body, right? So the digestion enzymes will access food material for the parasites when they are present in our body. Okay, not only in our body, but also in the body of animals. So they reproduce at faster rate. The reproduction process of these, you know, parasites is very faster. And around 70% are not visible. Around 70% of parasites are not visible. But if you see in the case of worm parasites, many of the worm parasites are visible, and approximately some of the worm parasites are 30 centimeters in length. So in many cases, as the live I have observed a person that, so if he is affected with a type of parasitic disease which I don't know, but if he open his mouth, then a parasite will be come out from his mouth. So I have seen this type of cases as a live example of this person. So in that way, the worm parasite will be 30 centimeters long. Okay, the parasites are not a disease, but they cause a disease. You know, parasites are not a disease, but they has ability, they has capacity to cause a disease. You know, the type of the disease which they form depends upon the type of parasite. Okay, so based on their living, the parasites are of two types, ectoparasite and endoparasite. So firstly, let us discuss about ectoparasites. These are the parasites that live on or in the skin, but not within the body of humans and animals. You know, normally the body, we have skin, right? So the worms will get attacked upon the skin, or else it will enter into the endodermis only, but it doesn't go deeply into our body. It affects only upon the skin type, but it releases the parasites, and that parasites will enter into our body. But the original parasite, the mother parasite, will not enter into our body. Okay, so that is mean by ectoparasite. And the disease which are caused by these ectoparasites are called ectoparasitosis. And this is an innate infection. That's nothing but normally this process takes place at the layer of the skin, right? So when the skin layer will get damaged, or as the skin layer will get infected, then a red color daughter-like structures will be visible on your skin, right? And that's nothing but naked infection. So you can see, the infection which has been caused on your skin can be visible. So it is said to be as naked infection. And the symptoms which you can see when there is an effect of these parasites on our body are itchy like nature, discomfort, annoyance. You know, annoyance is nothing but mentally disturbed. Okay, like that, you will feel mentally disturbed. That is nothing but annoyance. So next, the mortality rate is very low. That's nothing but the death rate of this when the death rate of a person when he is attacked with these ectoparasites is very low. But if you see in the case of endoparasites, the death rate is, I mean mortality rate is very, very high. Okay, so normally, what are the diseases which they cause? Ectoparasites, pediculosis, and scabies. And this pediculosis and scabies you can see in every human being. In every human being, once in a life, he will get attacked with this type of disease. Okay? And meiosis and tungiasis. These are the type of disease which can be seen in tropical and subtropical region only. So, what are the main diseases which these ectoparasites cause? Scabies, Crablos, pediculosis, and this is very much important, Lernocera branchialis. So now let us discuss about endoparasite. So here, if you see in the endoparasites are transmitted by the fecal oral route. That's nothing but, I have said you in the beginning only, fecal oral route. So here two words are mentioned, fecal and oral. Oral means from the mouth region, oral cavity we say, right? From the mouth region. And fecal is nothing but fecus matter which we release. So the process begins from the fecus matter only, where the eggs gets released in the fecus matter. So when we take contaminated food and water through the oral cavity, then what happens? Then the parasites will get developed in our body by depending upon the food material of gastric juices which are released by our, you know, which are released into our small intestine as well as the large intestine. So here from the fecal, it enters into the oral cavity, and that's nothing but fecal and oral route. So the endoparasites are transmitted by the fecal and oral route. Firstly, it will be released in the fecus matter, and then it will get transmitted into oral cavity. That's nothing but it will be get transferred into our mouth, and from the mouth, it enters into the small intestine as well as the large intestine, and totally it affects our body. So here endoparasites are transmitted by the fecal and oral route. They rely on third organism. That's nothing but they depend on the third organism. Here third organisms is nothing but, see, I will say enough. So I have said you, this endoparasites get transmitted by fecal and oral route. So between this fecal and oral route, there is an organism which plays a major role, where the parasites will get transmitted from the fecal and oral route. So that parasites will be taken up by mosquitoes, and this mosquitoes acts as third organism. So what is the main function of this mosquito? This mosquito acts as a third organism, where it takes the eggs which are present in this fecus matter and will get transmit that eggs into oral cavity. That's nothing but in the form of contaminated food and water, it transmits into oral cavity. That's nothing but into our mouth, and from the mouth intestine, and the process begins, their life cycle begins. So like this, they depend upon the third organism, which endoparasites begin their third organism, and the third organisms are called as carriers. Or the other name of these carriers are vectors, okay? So here the third organism, best example of the third organisms are mosquitoes. So next, mosquitoes acts as vectors. That's nothing but they act as vectors or as a carriers for many parasites. And the best example is malaria, which is commonly known for each and every person. So what are the three main type of parasites? Protozoa, helminthes, arthropods. These three are the main type of parasites. So now let us learn each by each. First one, protozoa. So firstly, protozoans are single-celled parasites. And these protozoans were firstly discovered by Antony von Leeuwenhoek. And this Antony von Leeuwenhoek, he discovered 45,000 species on this in these protozoans. There are different type of species which are regarding to these protozoans, and along with them 45,000 species are present in the protozoans. And normally these protozoans, which type of body system which will get affected? Infest blood, nervous system, digestive tracts of human being, not only in the humans but also in the animals will also get affected. So what are the main infections which are caused by these protozoans are Giardia lamblia, Entamoeba histolytica, Cryptosporidium. Toxoplasma gondii is very important, which you have to remember here. And here, symptoms. What are the major symptoms which you can see in a person who is infected with this type of parasite called protozoans are abdominal pain, fatigue, flush symptoms, weight loss, weakness and diarrhea. So this is the main important introduction which you have to remember in this protozoa. So coming to the second one, helminthes. So coming to the helminthes, these are worm-like parasites. So there are different types of worms like roundworms, tapeworms, hookworms, flukes. All of this comes under the classification of the endoparasites. But even helminthes also consists of leeches, right? Helminthes also consists of leeches, and these leeches are ectoparasites. You know about the leeches, right? It attacks upon the skin, only upon the skin, but it doesn't enter into our body. So this is the best example of the ectoparasite. What I have said here, ectoparasite, it will enter into the skin either at the epidermis layer or as endodermis layer, but it doesn't enter deep beneath the skin, right? So it is said to be as ectoparasite, and one of the best example of this ectoparasite is leeches, which comes under the classification of helminthes. Okay, so one of the famous roundworm is Trichinella spiralis. So this Trichinella spiralis is normally is a parasite which is present mostly in muscle tissue of pigs. Muscle tissue of these pigs. And from the pigs, it enters into humans. So how it enters into the humans? Either normally these pigs will release fecus matter, right? So there are many mosquitoes where this depends upon the fecus matter, and the eggs from this fecus matter will enter into the mosquito, and this mosquito acts as third organism, which I have said you before only. It acts as a third organism. So what happens is that it enters into the contaminated food and water, that eggs. Okay, that eggs will enter into contaminated food and water, and that contaminated food and water will be intake by the humans. That is one of the pathway, and there is another pathway this Trichinella spiralis can enter into humans. How? By the pigs. Normally human consumes pork, right? Pork. They will cook pork, and that if that pork is contaminated, then humans will also get affected with these parasites. Okay, so coming to the symptoms, if the person will be affected with these helminthes parasites, then the symptoms you can see in that person are diarrhea, abdominal pain, malaise or its weakness. So coming to the third one, arthropods. So these arthropods have tough exoskeleton and segmental bodies. Exoskeleton, tough exoskeleton is nothing but it consists of hard exoskeleton. So what is meant by exoskeleton? First of all, we all of us know that what is meant by exoskeleton. It is a type of outer skeleton which protects of the body parts, right? Which protects the body parts. So that exoskeleton will be very tough. I mean, it will be very hard, and segmented bodies. It consists of segments like this. If there is a worm like this, it will be segments. It consists of segmented body, and the best example for these arthropods are mosquitoes. And normally these mosquitoes mainly causes malaria, yellow fever, heartworm, elephantiasis and filariasis. So these are the diseases which are mainly caused by these arthropods. Okay, and normally you can find this normally the tough exoskeleton you can find in each and every parasite. And each and every parasite, but the segmented bodies you can see only in the rare conditions. But in every condition you cannot see this type of segmented bodies. Okay, so coming to the symptoms, abdominal pain, unexplained weight loss, fatigue, and vomiting. So these are the symptoms which you can see in the person who is infected, who is exposed to these arthropods. Parasites. So I explained many videos on the infections which are mainly caused by the different parasites like enterobiasis, trichinosis, Chagas disease, Trichuris trichura, giardiasis, Ancylostoma duodenale, Taenia solium, Yersinia pestis, Schistosomiasis, which is also called as Bilharzia, Leishmaniasis, Facial hepatica, Trypanosomiasis. So these are the diseases which I already explained in my previous videos. So normally all of this video will be present as a playlist called Parasitology, and the link of that Parasitology will be given in the description box. So people who are interested, you can open the link and you can watch these videos. And in each of the disease, I explained in the each of the video. So like enterobiasis is one of the video, trichinosis is one of the video, Chagas disease is another video. Like this, I have prepared many videos. I gave the deep information for all of these topics. So you can, if you have any doubts regarding this, all of these topics, you can ask me, and you can also join us in WhatsApp group. And the link of that WhatsApp group, how to join, invite link will be present, and that invite link is present in the description box. You can join us through WhatsApp group, so that if you have any doubts, or else if you want notes regarding this, all of these, all of these infections, or else all of these diseases, you can ask me in that WhatsApp group. I will explain to you properly, and or else I will give you the notes. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please you can comment in the comment box, or else you can ask in my WhatsApp group. Thank